Hello, friends. Today, we continue our series, our walk through the life of Joseph found in the book of Genesis. And today's lesson can be boiled down into one thought. When we don't know what to do, we remember that our problems can position us for a purpose. Our problems, the things that we're going through, can position us for something greater or something better or for something that God is going to do inside of us or with other people. So our position, our current problems can position us for a purpose. Now, one of my all-time favorite TV shows is Lost. Lost aired on ABC from 2004 to 2010, and I watched every episode as it happened. Still one of my all-time favorite shows. I'm currently working through the seasons. I'm in season two right now, currently. Love the show. But one of the great things about Lost is that it would tell stories, and the whole series was one story. But it focused on these main characters, and what they were is they were plane crash survivors on a deserted island, and all the twists and turns and everything that took place while they tried to survive on that island. And one of the storytelling techniques they used was the flashback. So they would take the current situation with them on the island, and they would take a main character, and they would flash back to a childhood, or they'd flash back to a memory from 5 to 10 years ago, or to right before they got onto the airplane, so that we were able to know a little bit more about this character. We can see what they were experiencing presently as they're on the island, but then what led them to get to that point. Now, some of them suffered tragic childhoods, or they had loss of significant relationships, or a family member died, and it was kind of the grief that they experienced in those flashbacks. And so these flashbacks really helped us to have, or to see and experience a complex and interesting and a compelling story. It really drove the series along, understanding more of the backstory, the flashbacks of these characters. And they were tough times, most of the flashbacks. They weren't easy, joyful times, but it was the tragedies and the things that set them up for when they were going to get on that flight out of Sydney, Australia, headed for Los Angeles before the plane ultimately crashed. And so pain, struggle, problems, these are the things that are part of our backstory. And if they're not, one day they will be. They may be part of our current story right now, and we don't understand what God's doing. We don't understand why we're experiencing the pain and the trouble, the struggles that we're going through. And it's hard for us to kind of comprehend and understand that. Well, the past few weeks, we've been talking about Joseph's life, and Joseph's life was not always easy. And there were times that Joseph didn't know what to do, but he would always look to God. In Genesis chapter 39, verse 2, the Lord was with Joseph. That's one of the hallmarks of Joseph's story, is that the Lord was always with him. And so today, we're talking about the heavy stuff, the things in our lives that oftentimes feel random or pointless or unnecessary, that pain and that struggle that we're going through. Those difficulties we experience, they often feel random, pointless, unnecessary as we're going through them. But we can remember that God can be using those to position us for a purpose in the future. It's hard for us to find answers in these situations. We want to always ask the question, why me? Why am I going through this? What about me drags me into this situation? In real life, unlike movies and TV shows like Lost, our struggles don't get wrapped up in a pretty bow within a half hour or an hour time slot. It can take years, hours, days for those moments to be wrapped up. And sometimes we may not understand while we're going through these situations why we're going through them. The outcome may not always turn out the way we want it to. In those times, though, it can be really difficult for us to see the point of our pain, the point of our struggle, the point of our frustration, to find that determination to keep going despite the difficulties, which really points us back to Joseph and the life that he was living and the things that he was struggling with, the things that he was going through. Just a quick recap of Joseph's story. He was the favorite son of his father, Jacob, and Jacob gave him this beautiful coat of many colors. And his brothers hated him because he got the coat and because he was the favorite. And because of that, they took him out into the desert, put him in a used, dried up well, and they waited for somebody to come by. And they sold him into slavery. Once in slavery, Joseph became a slave in the house of Potiphar, who was a big official of the Pharaoh, who was the king at the time. And then he was falsely accused of doing something that he didn't do. And so that's kind of where we find Joseph right now. He's been put in prison because of a false accusation made against him. He was accused of something, but Joseph stood firm and did not commit a sin against his boss, his slave owner, or his master is a better word, or his God. And so because he stood his ground and had character and integrity, he was thrown in prison because of it. He went from free man to slave, and now he's a prisoner. And that's where we pick up his story. A crime he didn't commit, he's there, but then Joseph meets some friends in prison. So let's start with Genesis chapter 40, starting in verse 1. Sometime after this, the cupbearer of the king of Egypt and his baker committed an offense against their lord, the king of Egypt. And Pharaoh was angry with his two officers, the chief cupbearer and the chief baker. And he put them in custody in the house of the captain of the guard, in the prison where Joseph was confined. So we see the cupbearer and we see the baker. They did something wrong that offended Pharaoh, and so what does he do? He just throws them in prison. And so Joseph meets them, verse 4 of chapter 40. The captain of the guard appointed Joseph to be with them, and he attended them. They continued for some time in custody. So Joseph, again, everything Joseph was doing as he was a slave, and even now as a prisoner, he was succeeding at, because the Lord was with him. And so when the cupbearer and the baker come into prison, the guard puts Joseph in there. It puts him in charge of them to help them, to, you know, to take care of them. That's what Joseph's role was. In verse 5, and one night they both dreamed. The cupbearer and the baker of the king of Egypt who were confined in the prison, each his own dream, and each dream with its own interpretation. When Joseph came to them in the morning, he saw that they were troubled. So he asked Pharaoh's officers who were with him in custody in his master's house, "Why are your face downcast today?" They said to him, "We've had dreams, and there's no one to interpret them." And Joseph said to them, "Do not interpretations belong to God? Please tell them to me." And so still, in the midst of what Joseph was going through, he still knew that God was there. And he still knew that God could do things that were incredible, could still do miracles, and knew that God could interpret dreams. He had dreamed long ago that his brothers would bow down to him. And now he's able to see another dream. And two dreams from the cupbearer and the baker, and he's able to interpret them. And even in this difficult situation, Joseph continues to rely on God. He still knows that God is there. And so with God's help, Joseph is able to interpret the dreams of the cupbearer and the baker. And he eventually tells them that the cupbearer is going to be restored. And then unfortunately for the baker, he's going to be executed. And Joseph just lays that out before them. And not 3 days later does what Joseph said happen. It happened. The cupbearer is restored, and the baker is executed by Pharaoh. But you would think that the cupbearer would go to Pharaoh and say, "Hey, there was this guy in prison who told me exactly what was going to happen." But the cupbearer doesn't do that. As soon as he gets out of prison, he just moves on with his life. He forgets about Joseph. For 2 years after this, Joseph is still stuck in prison, again, for a crime that he didn't commit. And Joseph's probably wondering at this point, has God forgotten about me? What is the point of all of this? I helped someone out and my life did not get any better. What in the world is going on? And he'd have a right to ask that question, you know, going through all of this stuff. But then one day, Pharaoh had a couple of dreams. And at that point, the cupbearer remembered Joseph. "Oh yeah, there was this guy in prison a couple of years ago, and he told me what my dream meant. Maybe you should go ask him." And so Joseph is brought before the Pharaoh, and he is able to, with incredible accuracy, tell the Pharaoh what was going to happen based on his dreams. And because of that, Joseph was eventually placed as second in command in all of Egypt, because there was going to be a severe famine. It was 7 years of abundance and then 7 years of famine. And because of Joseph being placed in second in command, he was put in a position that he could save Israel. Spoiler alert, he was able to also save his family who was in Israel, but up in Israel, and where they were starving as well because of the severe famine. We'll get to a little bit more of that next week. But because of Joseph's position, he was put there for a purpose. He started off as a slave, moved to prisoner, and now he's second in command in Egypt. Now, Joseph's life wasn't perfect because if he did something wrong, then he could wind up in prison again, just like the cupbearer and the baker. But Joseph didn't. The Lord was with him. Life may not have been perfect for him, but he was put in a position to where he could save all of Egypt, and he could save his own people. Even the problems he was facing, God had a purpose in allowing those situations in his life. So hard things and hard times will come in our lives. They'll be a part of our life. And it's important to remember that God is always there, and that God can use those things, those struggles, difficulties, the things that we're not enjoying about our life, that God can use those for his purpose. That they can be a part of our flashback later in life. They may not be fun currently as we're going through them. And as teenagers, we experience those difficulties of friends making fun of us, the ending of relationships, the not getting the good grades that we think we should get. But God can still use those as our backstory for a purpose in the future. Because of sin, that's why sometimes things bad happen to us. It may be our sin that's caused those things, or it may be the sin of other people that caused these bad things in our lives. But still, we know that God can use them for a purpose and for his glory. But when it seems like it's impossible that anything good can come out of a situation, we can remember that God is always there and that God can always do the impossible. He can do those things that we could never imagine could take place. God can do those for us. Romans chapter 8, verse 28. Paul wrote, "And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to his purpose." We know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to his purpose. That God has a plan for these struggles and these hard times in our life. And maybe we don't need to ask the question, why me? Or why am I going through this? But maybe we turn the question and we ask instead, God, what are you trying to teach me through this? Or God, how are you going to use this situation in my life in the future? You see, Joseph was uniquely set up to do what he was called to do. He was the one who was organized, and he was the one that God gave the gifts to take care of Egypt and his own family. And Joseph was the only one, I believe, that could do that. And so it's the same with our lives. God has a specific purpose for us and a purpose for the pain that we go through, that God can use those and position us for a purpose in the future. The hardest and the worst things we experience aren't the end of the story for us. In fact, they could just be a part of something even greater. I know times are tough, especially right now, with the unrest in our country, with the quarantine and the COVID virus, that there's just a lot on our plates. But I think we can know that God can work all things out for good, for those who are called according to his purpose, that God can position us, that these events and these struggles and these things in our life that are not fun, that God can use those for a purpose, for his purpose, for his glory, to bring honor to him. And we just need to remember that God is still in control. Regardless of what we see on TV or even out our windows, God is still in control. He still is Lord, and regardless of what happens, he still loves us. Things may not always be fun, but God is there for us. He's our encouragement. He's our love. He's our Savior. And we just need to remember that. And that's my encouragement for us today.